My first gig really was a bit disastrous because I thought that I had a bit of a sound system, and when I put my little record player that was in my bedroom into a big hall, it actually blew up for the first time. So I didn't have the very best of starts, but what was really great about it was that I actually got to play a few records for about an hour. And then at the time it was going for about an hour, it was really good, and I was very pleased that people that didn't know who Carl Cox was, they knew at the end there was the guy that the sound system blew up for the first time. And after that, I got myself a much better sound system, and then that helped me along my way. But yeah, it was an interesting start. The only advice I can give really to any aspiring DJ or anyone that wants to perform in this way is to basically, you know, do what feels good for you. Do what you believe in. Play the music that you feel good about. Try not to follow any fashions or any trends in music, because you'll be always behind the next person. So if you're into something that you really enjoy playing, and then basically playing out, whether it be dubstep, drum and bass, whether it be jazz, funk, soul or hip hop, it doesn't matter, as long as that you're feeling it, and then the people that come to see you, they get to feel it as well. Well, the thing is, first and foremost, you're doing something that you love, something that you have a passion for, something that basically is within you to be able to be that person that's responsible for many people's best time of their lives. It's a moment of which you create as an individual, because each one of those people that are looking at you are looking for something. And as long as you have something that you can give and you can share, that feeling is like nothing else you can ever imagine. Because basically, when you're sharing the love of music and the love of passion and by what you're creating, there's nothing better than that when it comes to really touching people's lives within a moment of what you're doing. And you can be as creative as you like, you know, with turntables, with the computer, with keyboards, with guitars. But the thing is, as long as people kind of give the love back, there's nothing else like it. I mean, if you look at many YouTubes of Carl Cox that I've done over many years, the only thing you see on my face is a big smile, and it's because I'm enjoying the moment, for sure.